Arriving at the White House, the big four foreign ministers. Lloyd of Britain. De Murville of France. And Russia's Andrei Gromyko. American Secretary of State Herter and the President greeted them later at the White House. All came to Washington from the recessed Geneva Conference to pay homage to John Foster Dulles. And at a private and off-the-record luncheon meeting, the President reportedly urged the strongest efforts be made to achieve progress. When the Geneva talks resume, the sessions will also be private, but hopes are high that the deadlock, apparent at the time of Mr. Dulles' death, can be resolved. This is Berlin, 6 months after Soviet Premier Khrushchev's ultimatum to demilitarize the city. On the deadline date, the Reds threatened to turn over control of the free city's arteries of communication to communist East Germany. But business goes on as usual in the enclave of freedom behind the Iron Curtain, and traffic between the free and Soviet zones continues in the usual manner. The daily U.S. military train from Frankfurt is on time after passage through Red East Germany. Flags throughout the free city are at half-mast in respect for John Foster Dulles as the six-month ultimatum period ends without crisis, a significant tribute in this focal point of Cold War tensions.